High Excellence presents Jewels from the Holy Quran, a series of lectures by Mufti Ismail Ibn Musa Menk.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most gracious, most merciful, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having granted us the completion of the Quran this evening, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from us. Wa usalli wa usallim ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa ba'd. Complete blessings and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us his companions in the akhirah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and our offspring. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really uplift us in every single way, in all forms of goodness. Ameen. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters, dearest listeners. Alhamdulillah, the aim and objective of the little portions of the verses that we have heard on a daily basis from the first day of Ramadan to today. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept them from us. The idea and the aim was solely the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The idea was solely to please my Creator and yours by mentioning His words, because it is definitely a duty on all those who know to explain to those who don't know. And it is important that every single one of us who know should teach those who don't know whatever they know. And whatever we do not know, we should try and go out and learn it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us all for that effort, inshallah. We should also remember that the messages that have come to us were for us, all of us. I should consider those messages for me personally. And every single one of you should consider the message for yourself, tailor-made. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us. If you notice, the messages are quite similar. All of them are messages that are related to human beings, related to the upliftment of human beings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to uplift all of us. It is also very important to note that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us auspicious months and occasions so that we can turn to Him. The losers are the ones who witness these occasions and don't turn. Those who plan a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates a barrier between you and the sin. Understand that that barrier was a gift. Those who plan something bad and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings in an auspicious month, an auspicious occasion, understand that that opportunity was for us to give up that bad plan or that bad idea. But those who do not turn and reminder after reminder comes to them, then there is sad news for those who do not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us turning. The idea also was to bring myself and yourselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by trying to understand His greatness, by trying to understand His verses, by looking at some of the secrets of the Quran, by looking at some of the deeper aspects of the Quran, by becoming proud Muslims who know that this Quran is definitely a book that we should be proud of. And also the aim that I have had when I came into this particular city of Cape Town was to bring the masses closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the power of Allah. Nothing is contributed to myself, absolutely nothing. It is solely the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nobody should think that crowds have come. The crowds don't mean anything. What means everything is if people have understood that they need to have become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah should accept it. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted it, even if there was one person in the masjid, it was enough. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rejected it, even if there are 5,000 in the masjid, we are losers. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. The question is, what is the sign of acceptance? I need to know it, and you need to know it, and we have been told it. If I want to know if this lecture was accepted, how do I know it? There is a clear sign, very clear. And that is, have I moved in any way spiritually? If the answer is yes, I've moved, inshallah, we are accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if I leave this place or leave the month of Ramadan and I return to my bad ways and habits, and it was just a good time we had in Ramadan, very nice Ramadan, then may Allah protect us. I don't even want to say what that means. So it is important that we ask ourselves on a night like this, an auspicious occasion. Inshallah, I will return after a few hours to speak once again, and then I will speak on Laylatul Qadr. Let me speak here about the concluding note, how we should have treated this whole month and how we should have benefited from it, and what criteria we should use to judge ourselves. Whether we have really been followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and whether we truly deserve the blessings and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've already told you. Quite simple. We ask ourselves, have I given up the bad that I was engaged in? Have I engaged in sincere tawbah? We need to answer these questions in our hearts. Have I promised Allah that I am going to mend my ways? Am I going to dress properly? Am I going to give up some of the evil or all the evil that I have been engaged in? Have I decided to transform my life? Am I going to read salah outside the month of Ramadan, the five salah? If that is the case and the answers are positive answers, inshallah, I give you glad tidings. Every single one of us will enter Jannah. Every single one of us will enter Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Kullukum tadkhuluna al-jannata illa man aba." Every single one of you shall enter Jannah, besides the one who refuses. Who refuses to enter Jannah? None of us. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Man ata'ani dakhala al-jannah wa man asani faqad aba." Whoever follows me will enter Jannah, meaning whoever follows Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will enter Jannah. And whoever disobeys me has refused to enter Jannah. So this is why we must ask ourselves, are we from amongst those who want Jannah? If that is the case, life is a struggle to become better every single day. The spiritual ladder, if for example it has 100 steps on it, if we were on step number 5 before Ramadan and now we've got to step number 6, wallahi we have achieved a lot. Wallahi we've achieved a lot. And if we've jumped from step 5 to step 50, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, we have achieved a great deal. We ask Allah to grant us steadfastness. But those who dropped from step 5 to step 4 or remained on step 5, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from shaitan. So a winner is the one who sees himself or herself heading in a certain direction. I am walking, I'm improving on a daily basis, I'm not going back. You know, when we have a business, and I've given this example in some of the talks, you have a little business, you start off, say, working for someone. After some time, you collect some money, you want to open your own little place. You open one little tuck shop, and after that, you want to have a bigger place. You were renting, then you decide to build. Now you have your property, and you have one shop. Alhamdulillah, it's yours. After that, what do you want to do? Do you want to close back and go back to your tuck shop and start working for someone again? No, that's not what we want. For money, we will never ever think that way. No, we won't. We know we need a new branch. Then we want another branch in Pal, not just here. Then we want one elsewhere, possibly in another city, and Joburg maybe. Gauteng, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all goodness. And if we had 20 branches across the country, we would be known as tycoons, alhamdulillah. May Allah make us tycoons in terms of reward and benefit in the month of Ramadan. The same applies if we can understand that example for money that is going to help us solely for a few years whilst we are in the dunya. What about understanding that for that type of currency that will assist us forever and ever thereafter? Our salah, our ibadah, our zakah, our sawm, all these acts of goodness, abstaining from haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all strong. So we've heard the message. We will continue hearing the messages. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must draw us closer to Him. And remember, you will gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you have a link with those who have knowledge. When you have a link with those who have knowledge, when you understand that you must ask them and you must create that link so that you can learn and you can be corrected where you are heading astray. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correct all of us and guide us. This city is blessed with some of the best reciters of the Quran in the whole country. And it is blessed with a large number of highly qualified ulama. The question is, how is my relationship with the ulama closest to my own home and house? That's the question. If I am distanced from them, what's the point of becoming close to someone who appears from far off when we are harassing and hassling the same people who are nearby? Let me give you an example. A man who has a heart disease. If there are doctors on his street, he will know all of them and he will make sure that they are his friends. He knows one day he might need them. And he knows that they need to now refer him to the specialists that you might find elsewhere. And if you have a heart specialist on your street, Allahu Akbar, you will probably buy a house right next door because you know I've got a heart problem. It's a fact. We understand it when we have a problem with our health. What about that heart which has a spiritual problem? We have spiritual cholesterol, that dirt in the spiritual blood. Who are those doctors? The ulama. They are there to tell you, to try and teach you, to guide you. Then what happens? We don't want to know them. So we suffer an angina attack, thereafter a heart attack, spiritual death, and we don't even know that the expert is our neighbor. Allahu Akbar. In the same way that when you go to a doctor, the doctor might say, I'm going to use a knife to rip up your ribs and to open your chest so that we can have an open heart surgery. That's the only way of survival. You would say, no problem. You will pay him to do it and you will sign indemnity to say, if I die, don't worry, you are forgiven. That's a fact. We all know that. What about when the ulama come and tell us words that we might not like? Those are the knives that are going through our hearts. But wallahi, if we are guilty of that cholesterol and dirt in the spiritual blood, we need to be from amongst those who can sign and say, Alhamdulillah, we thank you for what you've given us. Allahu Akbar. By the time the foreign alim comes from a different land to talk to us, we might have died. We would be foolish to fly out to Honolulu in order to have a bypass when we know that the experts are around in our own city. So this is something really we need to consider. What is the point of the masses who are close to an alim who is very, very far away in Makkah or Medina when we have ulama in our own city? I hope I have put this point in such a way that we've understood it. We need to get close to those ulama who are closest to us. Allah knows where we are living in our areas. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows why He put us there. He knows who was going to be born in that same locality. He knows who was going to be chosen to study the deen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِن كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. Let there be from every nation a group of people who shall go out and study the religion so that they can come back to their own people and warn them. So when we have ulama who have come back to us, they are assets. They are assets for our society and our community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us a link with the ulama. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the ulama, guide them as well, and use them to serve the deen. As I said, wallahi, you have an abundance of ulama in your city. So we need to ask ourselves at the end of this month, who are the ulama close to me? I am definitely going to attend their halaqat. I'm going to attend the lectures. I'm going to try and benefit in this way or that way. If we are a busy person who happens to have a schedule that we get up early morning, we go out and we come back late at night, buy some cassettes, buy some CDs, buy some form of books, read something, achieve something. That is your contribution to your religion. If you want to spread this deen and you feel you don't have knowledge, you can buy CDs, buy books, buy cassettes, distribute them, give them as gifts to others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write the reward for you. If you have found something beneficial, don't just keep it to yourself. Give it to others. You will also be a tool. When you arrive on the day of Qiyamah, you will see lots of rewards. مَنْ سَنَّ سُنَّةً حَسَنَةً فَلَهُ أَجْرُهَا وَأَجْرُ مَنْ عَمِلَ بِهَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. The one who sets a good example will have the reward of it, and anyone who has followed it up to the day of Qiyamah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use every single one of us to spread this deen, inshallah. And we must be exemplary Muslims. That is another point I'd like to stress today. We must have good character and conduct, no matter what wealth you have, what knowledge you have, what status you have, what good looks you have, no matter what Allah has given you. Remember, when you are with the people, you are one person just like them. You need to speak to them properly, address them correctly, no matter what color, no matter what type of person it is. Even if it is a non-Muslim, we need to address them with respect, with the idea that we are presenting the correct picture of Islam. Wallahi la an yahdi Allahu bika rajulan wahida khayrun laka min humurin nar. Wallahi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if one person is guided through you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is better for you than everything this world has in terms of the most expensive of materialistic items. So may Allah use us, inshallah. So we need to speak well, smile in our homes. Another piece of advice. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us towards the end of his life. What does he say? Be careful and watch your treatment of women. Make sure you understand how to treat them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. And this statement is so all-encompassing that it includes those who develop illicit relations with women. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. They need to be careful. Those who oppress women, whether they are husbands or children, or whether they are any way related to them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. We've spoken about that through the month as well. So we need to really be conscious of Allah, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, at all times. He is the one who is going to question us regarding absolutely everything. We need to have answers. So we've heard so many verses, alhamdulillah. We've heard throughout the month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have benefited myself firstly, before everyone else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant myself the elevation, inshallah. And may Allah grant it to all of us who are here, anyone who has heard, anyone who is going to hear in the future. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really accept us. The idea is solely to come above all the petty differences of the Muslim ummah and to bring them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us all closer to Him. Really, there is a lot that can be said. But what is the point of uttering so much that when a person goes home, they cannot remember? Rather, we utter a few things. Khayrul kalami ma qalla wa dalla. The best of speech is that which is short and to the point. If you notice, we've tried to stick to the half an hour limit on a daily basis. The limit was set by myself. But we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept that half an hour a day. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really to grant us all success in the dunya and the akhirah. Remember the dua for this eve. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. Oh Allah, you are the one, you love to forgive. You are most forgiving, so forgive us, ya Allah. If we have achieved forgiveness during this month of Ramadan, wallahi, we have achieved a lot. Foolish is he or she who achieves forgiveness and gets a clean slate and starts sinning again and writes all dirty things on the slate. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Really, let us try and pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here and now, ya Allah, we will be steadfast, we will come forth, ya Allah, we will try our best to be as upright as possible, we will try and fulfill our duties, won't we, inshallah? Inshallah. We will try and fulfill our duties, we will try and dress appropriately and address others appropriately as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us all. I make dua for all those who are here today, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I request duas from you as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really reward all those who have been instrumental in this particular session to occur and these sessions to happen, this month of Ramadan. Really, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to repeat it again and again, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us Jannah together with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the ultimate that I want and you want, inshallah. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad.